Good morning. Welcome to Wednesday, May 6th. Wednesday, May 6th. Here we are in the month of May. Just hoping that you guys are doing well. I'm going to go over your two activities for today. They're both in Seesaw. And so I just want to make sure that you have them. So your first one is your humanities. Remember, we're working with plants now and what they need to survive and what they can do. So complete all activities with a yellow, orange, and pink star, like these directions say. Remember, these videos are here for you if you have online access, a device at home, and if you do not, I have attached them for you in this message. So regardless of whether you're doing paper packets or online packets, you have the same information in the same directions as everybody else. So I'm going to go ahead and open up our humanities lesson for today. You're still going to be using that article from ReadWorks, okay, about Miss Johnson. If you are doing it in your paper packet, it asks you to go back to yesterday's humanities activity. If you're doing it online, you can access it here through our Google Classroom. That is our third grade Google Classroom for the teachers. Sorry, that's not for you guys. So here, if you click on classwork, it shows up Miss Johnson's plant experiment. If you're struggling with the vocabulary from yesterday, if you go to it through here or through Clever, you can watch the whole thing. Okay. So your yellow star for today, task number one, is going to be rereading the passage from yesterday. Okay, that is here, the next three slides for you if you're doing it online. If you're doing it on paper, it is in lesson one. Okay, it says underline in the passage the key details that help you to understand what plants need in order to survive. So, key details are those things that are important and are really important to the topic, being what plants need in order to survive. Okay, your next activity, your orange activity, says to reread it again. Remember, reading multiple times, then answer multiple choice questions 1 through 7. Make sure to go back into the text to prove your answers. You can underline or highlight with a crayon, pen, or marker where you found the answer. Answer short answer questions 8 through 10 with complete sentences. So if I go here, here's questions 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Those are all multiple choice. So one answer. And then 9, you've got three short answers. So complete sentence answers. Which plant gets water and a lot of light? Which plant does not get water and a lot of light? Okay, so which plant in the story? Okay, in the experiment. And then you've got your DLR for the day. Okay, make sure that you are knowing what synonym and antonym mean. Okay, synonyms and antonyms. In your math activity for today, if you're doing the paper packets, you don't need to do task two, but you can if you want to. I've gotten rid of it again. But we are continuing our work with the relationship between addition and subtraction. Or sorry, the relationship between multiplication and division. Oi, so sorry about that slip up there. Okay, so again, this video with the visual learning is linked here. It's a YouTube link from me. It is also here in Seesaw if you have access to Seesaw. So while it opens up, the first thing you're going to do, your yellow star, will be your daily math review. So make sure that you get into your daily math review. And the challenge, please try it. It's called challenge because it's supposed to be harder. But just give it your best shot. Some of you guys did really well with the challenges from last week. There were some hard ones, and especially the time and the elapsed time. Tomorrow during our Zoom, we're gonna do some work with elapsed time and how to solve those. Plus, Mrs. Sousa is coming back from her maternity leave on Friday. And so next week you'll be getting some videos from Mrs. Sousa dealing with elapsed time. Okay, so here's your challenge. It says create an additional problem that equals the value in the place value blocks below. Create an addition problem. So you can type it up over here if you want to, put a text box over here, or you can record yourself telling me an addition problem that equals the value of all of these. Remember, these are thousands cubes, hundreds blocks, tens, and ones. Okay, so this would be 2,436. So that must be the total for the answer to your problem. Okay, for task three, you're going to be completing questions 1 through 9 on the next page. So here's the next page. 1 through 5 are up in the box. 6, 7, 8, 9 are practice. Okay, so it says find the value for the question mark that makes each equation true. So blank divided by 4 equals 7. So use your multiplication. Remember, they're related. So 7 times 4 equals what? Remember, the inverse. And then for your pink star, your problems of the day, there are 2 problems here for you to do. Hey, if you have questions and this is not clear for you, please reach out to me. That's what I'm here for. I'm here to help you. I hope that you guys are enjoying your week and taking time to really practice your skills for what to do when you get worried and your square breathing. I look forward to seeing you at 10:30 tomorrow morning for our Zoom. Bye, you guys.